so let's get into the first story. The first story is Rocket League will be going free to play next week, and it will be delisted from Steam because it is now a Epic Store only game. So Rocket League will be taken off of Steam. You'll still be able to play it, and you'll still be able to get the updates if you already have it on Steam, but it will be going free to play on Epic Store, and you guys can download it if you don't have it already, which I'm assuming everyone that's playing this game, honestly, probably already, you know, everyone that wants to play the game probably already has it. It's been out for like 4 years. The next one is apparently Fortnite has a split screen mode. I'm not really sure when this game got a split screen, but I know it hasn't always had it. So right here it says, while Fortnite is available on just about every system under the sun, split screen mode is currently limited to Xbox One and PlayStation 4. The feature was added in 2019. Okay, so split screen was added in 2019. Apparently nobody talked about it then. And Epic Games hopes to roll out a feature to PC and Switch users in the future update. We're pretty deep into 2020 and we still have no word on when that update will happen. Until then, the mode is limited to Microsoft and Sony consoles. I'm not really sure, honestly, why you'd need split screen, because Fortnite's playable on just about everything. So, you know, as long as you have like two devices, like even a phone, you can probably play Fortnite. But you know, split screen, I always will say this, split screen in a game gives it +1 point from me. Okay, I don't care what game it is, if it has split screen, automatically +1 to the points. All right, so Fortnite, even though I don't play it and I don't really care for it, it gets a +1 point for just having split screen. All right, Spotify is joining the very long list of everyone who hates Apple. I don't know how, you know, longer this list can get, because just about everyone hates Apple now. They say, once again, Apple is using its dominant position and unfair practices to disadvantage competitors and deprive consumers by favoring its own services. We call on competition authorities to act urgently to restrict Apple's anti-competitive behavior. The reason they don't want competitors on their stuff, or any competitors period, is because they don't do anything. They haven't done almost anything in the past couple years, okay? They barely do anything each year. That's why they don't want competitors, because all their competitors are better than them. They just don't want it, because they know if they have competitors, no one's gonna choose them. And the people that are still using Apple products, I mean, I don't understand why, to be honest. All right, for something, you know, less, you know, not as bad news or anything like that, we got some just funny news or something. Skyrim gets a Fall Guys mod, so you can have Fall Guys in your Skyrim, and apparently they'll steal your sweet rolls, so you're gonna want to watch out for them if you do add them into your game. It kind of looks funny. As you can see in the background, you got a bunch of Fall Guys fighting bandits and stuff. I don't know, that might be worth checking out. Red Dead Online gets another useless update. They add legendary rams and no one cares, because they still have not added, after 2 years, some like criminal roles, like some like role where you can rob a bank or in stagecoaches and trains and have missions like that. Nope, we don't have an outlaw yet, but hey, you can hunt rams. Borderlands, now this is crazy, because I thought Borderlands was one of those games that was gonna be like, you know, I thought this company was gonna be like all the other companies that are like, hey, you gotta pay to get the next gen features and stuff. But Borderlands 3 is getting a free PS5 and Xbox Series X upgrade and 4-player split screen, 4K 60fps, and single player, free to current gen owners who own the next gen consoles. So I mean, that's a plus. I mean, there's nothing negative about that, so that's pretty cool. Grand Theft Auto company boss isn't sold on video game subscription services. Apparently he doesn't think the subscription game subscription services like Xbox Xbox Game Pass are going to be around that long, and he doesn't, you know, care for them. But what he does care about is putting casinos and slot machines in the game and getting your money. Xbox Cloud Gaming launches today. It's launched today. It says tomorrow, but I pulled this article up yesterday, so it is today, with more than 150 games. If you have Xbox Game Pass Ultimate, you'll now be able to stream 150 games to your mobile device, your computer, your Xbox, whatever it is. I don't really know why you'd need it on the PC or Xbox, but if you're on your phone, you can live stream a game to there and play some Xbox games, I guess. Apparently some of the games you'll be able to play is Gears 5, Halo the Master Chief Collection, and Forza Horizon 4. Fallout 76. One Wasteland update makes it easier to explore and play with friends. So basically, the update that people have been waiting forever for this game to make is finally here. So you can now travel anywhere with any level character in Fallout 76 with your friends or by yourself, because the enemies will actually adjust their levels to you instead of adjusting their levels to either certain areas or a higher level player that's already been through that area. Then the enemies will be there. So now if you go into an area, they should adjust to your level and your stats, and XP will be based on your own level, and it will bring them up if you're way more powerful than them, and then it'll bring them down if they would normally crush you. At least that's what it says. So, you know, I don't know why that wasn't in the game from the start. Well, I do know why, because they didn't care. But that should be in like every game, like Fallout 76, you know, that has levels like that and it's online. That should be in like every game like this. I don't know why it took them so long. Xbox Game Pass is getting 5 more games. So it will be getting Halo 3 ODST, which no one cares about. I'm not saying it's a bad game, it's just they did some stuff to it, you know, with the police stuff, and I just don't care about it. So, you know, I just don't care about it anymore, because when you remove something from a game that's been out for years, because, you know, some people are whining, I don't care anymore. It will also come out with Warhammer Vermintide 2, Night in the Woods, Company of Heroes 2, and I think that is it. Master Chief Collection. Oh, Destiny 2 too. So yeah, 5 new games if you have Xbox Game Pass, 5 more games that you'll be able to play. Razer has a data leak that may have exposed info of over 100,000 customers. So that is never good. So if you have a Razer account, you should probably check or, you know, change your password or something, because you could possibly be one of these people that your data has been leaked. I mean, it really won't do you much good now, because they already have your information if they do, but, you know, maybe change your password and stuff just to be safe. All right, another ridiculous story is Arby's is now going to be getting Cuphead toys. So you can now get some Cuphead toys by going to Arby's and getting a meal. So I'm assuming it's like a kid's meal or something. But you can go to Arby's and get some Cuphead toys. I never thought I would see the day where Arby's would be giving out some Cuphead toys. Or, to be honest, really any fast food place. Burger King, McDonald's, Wendy's. I just wouldn't think of the day where they'd be giving out, you know, Cuphead toys. Radeon reveals the design of its new graphics card, but instead of posting it online or something, They put it in Fortnite, and then they revealed it in Twitter. So that's kind of weird. I don't know why you would, you know, need to reveal your graphics card in Fortnite. I guess, you know, you just have a giant sponsorship in Fortnite so everyone would see it. But this is kind of like putting ads in games, really. Why would you even have a giant graphics card in the game? Last but not least, Take-Two CEO doesn't think cloud gaming is the future. As the CEO of Take-Two Interactive Software, which publishes some of the biggest games out there, he doesn't see cloud gaming making a huge difference to his business. His lack of enthusiasm in an in-depth interview. So he just doesn't think cloud gaming is the future, and that is going to be doing very well. And you know what? I can kind of see that because the biggest one that was supposed to be coming out was Google Stadia, and we know how that went. It was terrible because they put no effort into it. The NVIDIA one, I think, is probably the best one, even though it's a little bit more limited than some of the other ones, because people just start taking their games off of the service. I don't know why. You still have to buy the game. You're still making money. Why can't they just stream it from the NVIDIA service? It's not like, you know, they don't have to pay you for the game. They still have to buy the game to be able to stream on the NVIDIA service, but they just take it off for some reason. But I kind of also agree a little bit that cloud gaming isn't necessarily going to be that big right now. But I think in like 10 years or so, there's going to be a lot more cloud gaming stuff. But you know, this is also the guy. I don't, you know, think this guy is really, I don't know, something. Because this guy doesn't think cloud gaming is the future. He also doesn't like game subscriptions. He don't think that is going to work either. But this is the guy that will, you know, increase the price on his games. Like 21, NBA 2K21, you know, the basketball game. He's defending a price increase about that. But, you know, he doesn't want... cloud gaming or game subscriptions, but he'll charge you extra money to buy his game that is already stuffed full of microtransactions and slot machines.